Hello everyone and welcome to another episode about Elementor. My name is Robert and in this video I will show you how to make Elementor templates look good on mobile. Google loves mobile responsive and mobile friendly websites that are thoroughly optimized for such devices. So keep watching if you want to learn how to optimize your Elementor templates for mobile, step by step. You can start with a template from the library or create one from scratch. I already have a custom page here with 4 sections, which is not optimized for mobile quite yet. Don't worry about the tablet optimization for now. You probably get less than 3% of traffic from there. If you carefully look at some data on your Google Analytics, you can see that 60% plus visitors come from mobile. If I switch from desktop to mobile, the text looks awful. So let's change that. Click on the first element you want to optimize. Go to the Style tab and adjust its size. Do the same with the following text line and so on until you get the best look. I think that the WordPress template sentence should have a more significant size to pop out. So, let me drag this cursor until the text becomes what I want. It looks much better now. Feel free to do some finishing touches before moving on, depending on how much text you have and how many lines. I want to add more space between the text and the button on mobile. So click on the button, go to the Advanced tab, and add top padding of 30 pixels. Adjust the size of the text only if you want that, and move to the next section. Let me show you one more thing before moving on. This is important if you want to display the left or the right side of the image on mobile. To do that, click on Edit Section over here and change the background position in this drop-down. If you choose Center Right, for example, the right side of your image will appear on mobile. By choosing the Center Left option, you see the left side and so on. This could be a great way to focus on specific portions of your images. We are done with this section, so I'll click Next. If you want to see how to connect these buttons with your sections, leave a comment below and I will make that video for you. For this section, I will optimize the title as well as the content below. So, click the first and go to the Style tab. I think 34 pixels is perfect. Now move on and adjust the height of the spacer, which is 10 pixels minimum. If you want to turn it off completely on mobile, go to the Advanced tab. Look for the responsive menu and turn on the Hide on Mobile option. You can use the same trick for all the elements you want to hide on mobile and tablets as well. I think I can add one over here manually. Let's check it out. I was right, but to keep things simple, I guess the best way is to turn it off completely. Let me show you how to adjust the padding of the icon box. It's too big right now for the mobile view. Go ahead to the Advanced tab and add 20 pixels all around. Do the same with the following icon box and so on. The padding on the desktop view is 50, but that is too much on mobile. Carefully optimize each element for mobile and then move to the next section. Start with the spacers, then adjust the size of the button. You can select a different type in this drop-down. Choose the justified alignment and pick the extra small size over here. Or simply go to the Style tab and adjust the size. I think 17 is perfect on mobile for this widget. Maybe 24? And I think that the center alignment is better. Yeah, much better. If you change your mind and want the text to be smaller, or you have a large text with more words, go back to the Style tab and pick the number you want. Now we can move to the next section and adjust the size of the title. You can change the value by moving the cursor to the right or left, but for a more accurate number, use these arrows. Go ahead and optimize the spacers and then add some space above the first widget. Click on it to access its settings. Go to the Advanced tab, unlink the padding, then add 20 pixels to the top. Go down to the last widget and add 20 pixels to the button this time. That's it. Now go ahead and adjust the spacers of the last section. The button, which text size was set to 24 pixels, I guess. And then optimize the elements below. Make the text smaller. 27 is perfect. Adjust the size of the social icons in the Style tab, the phone number, and so on. I think the phone number could be 17 pixels, or a little bit more. The email should have the same size, as well as the street address below. Feel free to make the item you want to highlight bigger than the others. You don't have to follow exactly what I am doing. Click Update once you are done and check out the preview. Nothing changed for the desktop view, but if I make the window smaller, you can see that the text shrinks up automatically when the width goes below a specific size. This is the fastest way to check out if your website is mobile responsive. For a better mobile friendliness, make sure the navigation is smooth and people understand what you do and how you do it without searching for that information too much. I think a one-page website with sequential navigation and a pinpoint focus on what is essential could generate a higher conversion rate. What do you think about that? Let's start a conversation in the comment section below. I would like to find out your opinion. Make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified when I upload the next video. See you there. Cheers.